Okay, so welcome to the class. What we are going to do today is we are going to learn about Ashwini Nakshatra, different attributes given to Ashwini Nakshatra, and by the end of the class we will also see remedies for Ashwini Nakshatra. And what we are dealing with in the class is serious predictive astrology. By now, what you know about nakshatras is stories, etc. But those stories are not, doesn't give you a complete picture. So today we are gonna know about Ashwini Nakshatra, Ashwini Nakshatra in detail. We'll look at the Ashwini Nakshatra in a very in-depth way. So coming about the mantra that is given for Ashwini Nakshatra, these mantras are, important. You should know the meaning of these mantras to master the result of the nakshatras. Ashwino Rashva Yuzo Gramaha Prastastena Avastata. This is the mantra for Ashwini Nakshatra. It means Ashwino Yujo. Ashwini Nakshatra is a twin. Ashwini Nakshatras are two horses. Okay. Gramaha, who rule over a village. Paratsena avastata, and they also rule over the army of the village. Because of the rulership over army, you know what Ashwini Kumaras, who are Ashwini Kumaras? You know Ashwini Kumaras as the healer, right? You know Ashwini Kumara as healers. But is it true, are Ashwini Kumaras only healers? Or what do you think? Ashwini Kumaras are only healers? No, they are not only healers. They are also king. Ashwini Kumaras are the king. In the ancient times, Ashwini Kumaras were worshipped by the kings. You heard of Ashwamedh Yajna. That Ashwamedh Yajna, although it took a distorted form later on, initially, Ashwamedh Yajna was tying a rod, like a golden rod or a golden, like a golden stick to a horse, right? And letting it free to run anywhere in all the territories and all the places. And whichever village the horse will go, whichever country the horse will go, it is considered that the king of that country have given himself to the main king who is doing the Ashwamedh Yajna. Is going to work under that particular king, accepts the lordship, accepts the kingship of the prime king who is doing the Ashwamedh Yajna. Getting my point? This is the real Ashwamedh Yajna, and later on, at later point of time, Ashwamedh Yajna came as, the killing of horses for the sake of fire sacrifice. Later on, it became a destruction. So Ashwini Kumara generally indicate kingship, rulership. They are not only the divine healers, although yes, Ashwini Kumaras are the divine healers, but more than being the divine healers, they are the kings. So you know that Ashwini give you the healing properties, Ashwini makes someone a healer. But along with making that healer, it also indicates kingship. Ashwini also indicates kingship. For this particular reason, it is told, I think in Saravali, that if Venus is in Ashwini Nakshatra, it gives a Raja Yoga. Do you get my point? Any planet in Ashwini Nakshatra is supposed to give you a Raja Yoga. Because Ashwini Kumaras are the king. point one, right? So it is good for profession. Rajyoga, normally meaning the combination for kingship, indicates that there will be success in profession. The person will have a good, easy life, and he will be able to get financial stability, etc. as well. So any planet in Ashwini Nakshatra is good for profession. And when you do a nakshatra analysis, let me make something clear to you. Forget that Ashwini is ruled by Ketu. That is unauthentic. So forget that thing that Ashwini is ruled by Ketu. Ashwini is ruled by no one. Ashwini is just Ashwini. Generally, while doing the nakshatra analysis, we don't resort to the ownership of houses. If there is, suppose say, Mars in Ashwini Nakshatra or Mercury in Ashwini Nakshatra, then you cannot say that Mercury is the lord of the third house and fourth house and then the result will come. No. That is just 20% part of it. 80% of Nakshatra Jyotish depends on the signification of the planet. Getting my point? Why Venus in Ashwini Nakshatra will give you a Rajyoga? Because Venus, by his natural signification, is the significator for luxury. Getting my point? So for this particular reason, for Venus being the significator of luxury, Venus being in Ashwini Nakshatra is considered good for Rajyoga. So generally, whenever you do a nakshatra analysis, you should depend more on the natural signification of the planet than the house lordship of the planet, right? Make this one clear, principle very clear. Okay. So Ashwini Kumara. Ashwini Kumara is very good for professional success. It is very good for finance. It is very good for winning, conquering. Got my point? Primarily, the judgment is from the signification. That doesn't mean that you will ignore the house lordship. Getting my point? House lordship is also important. I'm just saying that house lordship is 20% important. Okay? So if the sixth lord is in Ashwini, then as I told you, the story of the Ashwini Kumara, Ashwamedh Yajna specifically tells us that the king is undefeated. The horse will go from one kingdom to another kingdom. And no king will stop the horse. If any king will stop the horse, then the main king who was doing the Ashwamedh Yajna, who let the horse run, will fight with that particular king. Getting my point? And Ashwamedh Yajna is done only when the king thinks that he have won the whole world, whole neighborhood area, whole territory, complete country. Rama, after killing Ravan, when he comes back to Ayodhya, after that, he does an Ashwamedh Yajna. Even after Lav Kush's war, he does an Ashwamedh Yajna, right? And Lav Kush will stop the horse. Yeah, this is the story. So Rama have went all from North India to Sri Lanka, have won the country. So, you know, a young king is not going to do an Ashwamedh Yajna. An old king who thinks that my authority cannot be challenged will be doing Ashwamedh Yajna. Getting my point? So Ashwini Nakshatra is very much related to authority not being challenged. Whichever planet is in Ashwini Nakshatra, the authority of that planet cannot be challenged. That planet is very prominent in the horoscope. That planet can be in any house. That planet can be in third house, sixth house, any house it can be. The planet need not be in the ascendant, need not have any connection with the ascendant. But because the planet is in Ashwini Nakshatra, he will gain prominence and the horoscope, the nature and the character of the person will go according to the nakshatra, according to the planet in Ashwini Nakshatra, right? Point one. Point two is it indicates kingship and Rajyoga. I have been telling this point again and again. I will tell it again. It indicates kingship and Rajyoga. So there is, you know, the person is unchallenged. in the signification of the planet in Ashwini Nakshatra. The planet in the Ashwini Nakshatra also gives kingship, easy money, and professional success. So if there is sixth lord in Ashwini Nakshatra, then your enemies cannot defeat you. Getting my point? Or if Saturn, the Karaka of misery, Karaka of disease, is in Ashwini Nakshatra, then disease cannot defeat you. If Mars, the Karaka for fight, is in Ashwini Nakshatra, then this person cannot be defeated in a fight. If Mercury is in Ashwini Nakshatra, then this person cannot be defeated in writing. If Jupiter is in Ashwini Nakshatra, then this person cannot be defeated in, you know, the knowledge, speaking, oratory. If Venus is in Ashwini Nakshatra, then this person cannot be defeated in the traits of Venus. This person cannot be defeated in the matters of romance, etc. If Sun is in the Ashwini Nakshatra, then the person cannot be defeated, cannot be challenged in his authority. Only for this particular reason, Sun is exalted. Sun is the significator of power, and it will become in Ashwini Nakshatra. It will go in Ashwini Nakshatra, the first 13 degree 20 minutes of Aries. It will behave like exalted, because now the king cannot be challenged. That is the happiest position for Sun to be in. Also, because the Ashwini Nakshatras are related to Rama, as I told you, Ashwamedha Yagya was done by Rama, right? But for marriage, Ashwini Nakshatra is not good. Getting my point? How you do the Nakshatra analysis is a very important thing. Very, very important. Let me be very honest with you. Okay. Any planet in Ashwini Nakshatra, his traits are very good for profession. Okay. So Mercury in Ashwini Nakshatra, if you go to a writing profession, it will be very good. Jupiter in Ashwini Nakshatra, if you go to the, you know, knowledge distributing oratory based profession, or, you know, the oratory skills, the speaking skills regarding the profession of this person is very good. But for the matters of marriage, this planet is bad. Why? Because Ashwini Nakshatra is a couple. It indicates two. Right? Ashwino or Ashwayujo. Ashwinis are the two horses. Because of this duality, the first marriage is never a success. Or rather to say, there are multiple marriages. Whichever thing comes in Ashwini Nakshatra, that thing is in multiple amount. Do you get my point? That particular thing is in multiple amount. Isn't a great amount. And the seventh lord being in Ashwini is not very good, because then marriage is in multiple amounts. The relationship is in multiple amounts. And that is not good. Whereas if the fourth lord is there in the Ashwini Nakshatra, it is very good for property. There are multiple properties. If it is very good for vehicle, there are multiple vehicles, but it is not good for mother. The father may have a second marriage, or the father may have an extra or a secret affair. Mind something. Nakshatra indicates unperishable karma. Nakshatra indicates those karmas which cannot be avoided. Getting my point or not? Nakshatra indicates those karmas which, you know, cannot be avoided. The karma have to be there. The karma will always be there. Right? For an example, let me go to the horoscope of Adolf Hitler. You can see the horoscope right now. Sun and Mercury are in the Ashwini Nakshatra, in the seventh house. Seventh house also indicates war. Seventh house also indicates relationship. In the matters of war, Adolf Hitler have been successful. Like no one can win the whole world, but he have been successful, right? Because seventh house also indicates fight, and Sun and Mercury being in the seventh house in Ashwini Nakshatra, the person has been very good in fight. But regarding relationships, Hitler was not very successful. He had multiple relationships with multiple women. and he loved Eva Baron and he was not able to get married to her. He and Eva Baron committed suicide together. So Ashwini Nakshatra in the 7th house with two planets there, not very good for marriage. And you know what? There is Mercury in Ashwini Nakshatra. What does Mercury indicate? Mercury indicates speech, right? Adolf Hitler was very influential in his speech. When he used to speak, when he used to give a speech, people used to get mesmerized. People used to get faint, tremble with fear or tremble with joy. Only on the, you know, on the powers of the speech, he was able to get such a huge support for himself. And also, there is Sun in Ashwini Nakshatra. Once again, he had been like an unchallenged king. He was challenged once, died once. Right. But other than that, his growth, his progress have been like quite remarkable, getting up on Sun in Ashwini Nakshatra. The person will, people will know you after your death also. Sun in Ashwini Nakshatra, people will know you for your, after your death also. And other nakshatras also indicate fame after death. But the fame of Ashwini Nakshatra is a kind of a bad fame, specifically with Sun in Ashwini Nakshatra. Whichever the planet who is in Ashwini Nakshatra, that gives you the trait for which you will be known even after your death. I'm getting my point. And Sun, Mercury, Hitler is known even to this day for his speaking skills and for his skills of leadership, etc. Understood? Is there any problem in understanding this particular thing? No problem? If there is any problem, write it to me. Like make a comment or write it in the chat box. Ashwini Nakshatra along with this also indicates a community. As we have seen in the mantra, right? Ashwino Rashu Yujo Gramaha Parastat Sena Avastat. Ashwini is also related to community or a village. So the sense of community, the sense of belonging to a place, the sense of these are my people is very strong with Ashwini. Getting my point? You know, there are people who are proud of their heritage, proud of their inheritance. That comes from Ashwini Nakshatra. Getting my point? That the proud of lineage, proud of your birth conditions, being proud of your family, being proud of your clan, being proud of your village is a trait of Ashwini Nakshatra. Do you get my point? For an example, let me give you one particular example. Before I give you that example, mind something. If the lagna is 11 degrees, okay? Every house is supposed to be of 11 degrees only. Getting my point? If the lagna is 11 degree, every house is 11 degree, okay? If the lagna is 20 degree, every house is 20 degree. Basic concept. See, this is the horoscope of Narendra Modi ji. Modi ji, Modi Shah. Now, the lagna is 11 degrees. The horoscope that I am using, Libra Ascendant, many people take Scorpio also, but leave it. Right? I take 11 degree, Libra Ascendant. If Ascendant is 11 degree, 7th house is also going to be 11 degree. And 7th house is Aries. In Aries, 11 degrees will be Ashwini. Right? There have been many prime ministers in India by now. But none of them very strongly none of them very strongly represent the place from where they belong. Getting my point? In the speech, in the style of Manmohan Singh, do you know from where he belongs? Of course, he's a Sikh, that is okay, that you know from his appearance. But a Delhi Sikh or a Punjab Sikh, what type of Sikh? Do you know that? Or where did Jawaharlal Nehru belong to? Or Indira Gandhi belong to? Or Rajiv Gandhi belong to? Getting my point? That pride of that I am born in Allahabad, we are from UP, that pride is not there. Abdul Kalam, have you ever saw in any activity of Abdul Kalam that tells us that, oh, that I am from Tamil Nadu? No. We generally don't know the ancestry or the heritage of any of the prime ministers. But for Mr. Modi, for our Prime Minister Modi ji, we very strongly know that he's a Gujarati. That particular aspect of it, that particular aspect of that I am Gujarati. You remember his first 2014 election, the Gujarat model of development. 7th house, as I told you, in the house of competition. And there is Ashwini in the 7th house. The Gujarat model of development, right? 7th house is also marriage. So his marital life have also been, isn't it? His marital life have also been very much discussed. But is Ashwini good for marital life? No. So for Mr. Modi, the ascendant being 11 degrees in Libra, the 7th house have to be 11 degrees in Aries. That comes into Ashwini. Remember, Ashwini will have three nakshatras, Ashwini, Bharani, and Kritika. And Bharani is good for marriage. Bharani is good for marriage. Bharani means what? Completion. The desire to have something. The desire to fill. That is good for marriage. The desire of compliment. That is good for marriage. But Ashwini is not. Because Ashwini Nakshatra falls in the 7th house of Narendra Modi ji, his marital life have not been good. Right? Do you understand? So Ashwini Nakshatra, and this much information we just know from the mantra. Ashwino Rashuyo Gramaha Prastata Sena Avastata. We know three things. First of all, the sense of belonging from a lineage, the sense of belonging from a particular place, the pride of the community is strong with Ashwini. Point one. Very strong professional success is given by Ashwini. But marital life is there. These three things we understand, right? No problem about it. No confusion about it. Or there is any confusion. Now there is one more section that Ashwini is a Chipra Nakshatra, Tiryagmukha Nakshatra, Mandi Nakshatra, etc. Right? And we have learned about this in the first section of the course. Have you gone through all the videos of the first section? We have dealt about these particular things, right? Andaman, the Kan, Sulochan, and different. So there are classifications of nakshatras, and we have gone through the classification of the nakshatra in the part one of the course, right? So I'm not going to repeat that again. Okay? I'm not going to repeat that again. But the horse, right? Ashwini is the horse. And from horse, you can get three more significations, okay? First of all, Ashwini means horse, and horse, Aswa, is related to things happening early in life. Getting my point? Whichever house Ashwini is there, whichever house Ashwini is there, things related to that house fructify very early. Okay? If you have any planet in Ashwini in the third house, or if you have Mars in Ashwini, or if you have third lord in Ashwini, then after your birth, your sibling was born quite early. Generally, for the happiness of the mother, for the good health of the mother, there should be 2 years difference between two child, right? At least 2 years difference between two child. But generally, when the third lord is in Ashwini or Mars is in Ashwini or the Ashwini is in the third house, in that scenario, generally the younger sibling is less than 2 years old. Like less than having 2 years of difference. Getting my point? The things of Ashwini happen very early. For Adolf Hitler, relationships started very early. For Narendra Modi also, he got married very early. So Ashwini is related to speed, things happening early. Okay? Mind it. Mind this particular thing. If the 10th Lord is in Ashwini, the profession may start very early. The professional life may start very early. And by this way also, with this sense of speed, Ashwini is also related to vehicles. Vehicles are speed, right? Vehicles have speed in them. So for that reason, Ashwini is also related to speed. Ashwini is also related to vehicles. Right? For an example, right, here we go. So this is the horoscope of Vin Diesel. Rahu is in the seventh house. See, seventh, which houses indicate fame? First house, seventh house, 10th house. These three houses indicate fame. Okay. Technically, first house and 10th house indicate fame, but 7th house planet will be influencing the first house. And 4th house will be influencing the 10th house. So technically, all the four Kendras indicate the fame. Normally, the ascendant and the 10th house indicates the fame. So Rahu is in the 7th house in Ashwini. Okay. Rahu is in the 7th house in Ashwini. Vin Diesel got high level of fame and recognition because of his movie, because of him appearing in the Fast and Furious series, I think, right? Things related to vehicle, Fast and Furious series, right? Right. Do we understand it? Before I go further and explore it in depth, by the end of the video, we will also be segregating difference between the different padas of nakshatra, right? The first pada of Ashwini, the second pada of Ashwini, the third pada of Ashwini, fourth pada of Ashwini. But for now, mind one thing, okay? First pada is dharma, okay? Dharma. First pada is dharma. Dharma related to that house, okay? Dharma is not very good. Okay? It is just the upliftment. Okay? Dharma is what? Dharma is doing the needful. Okay? So dharma is very limited. The first nakshatra, the first pada of Ashwini nakshatra, which will be dharma, have things in limited. Dharma is just as needed. Getting my point? Fame as needed. Just the sufficient amount of it. Dharma is sufficient. So Ashwini nakshatra, first pada, just sufficient dharma. Just sufficient fame. Just sufficient power. And just sufficient problem in marriage. Anything that is good is bad at the same point of time, right? So first is dharma, and dharma is just sufficient. Things are available in just sufficient amount. The second pada is artha, And artha means wealth. Getting my mind? Artha is what? Artha is wealth. So the artha part of any nakshatra indicates the accumulation. Okay? So Ashwini nakshatra, second pada. The person is in the process of accumulating power. The person is in the process of accumulating disaster in marriage. The person is in the process of accumulating fame. Getting my point? So second is artha, accumulation, in the process of accumulating. Second pada of any nakshatra will generally delay things. Second pada of any nakshatra will generally delay the things. Because it is in the process of acquiring. Getting my point? And the acquiration will take some time. To acquire it completely, it will take some time. So although Ashwini is a very fast nakshatra, if the second pada of Ashwini is activated, then the result will not come early, but will come late. Okay? We will go to the padas of nakshatra in depth later on in this video itself. Right? The third pada is kama. And kama is desire. Right? The kama is desire. So in kama, the things are just increasing and increasing. Kama, desire is good for hypnotizing people, is good for success. Kama, to understand kama, kama is to acquire happiness and to give happiness. Kama is generally misunderstood by sexuality. Well understood, see, like any type of a relationship. Kama is a relationship. Any type of relationship is happiness for both the people, right? Both the people. So that is the sense of kama. Giving something, taking in return. Filling a void and getting rewarded is kama. Third pada. And the fourth pada is moksha. Moksha is running away. Moksha will have two meanings. Either running away or surpassing the thing. So either the moksha is running away from responsibilities, Or he already have done something that the responsibilities will be taken care of automatically. So now see the three charts again. The chart of Mr. Vin Diesel, Rahu in the seventh house in the third pada of Ashwini, Kama, right? So that's why he is getting fame. Kama. Fame because of Ashwini. Fast and furious, right? In the horoscope of Mr. Narendra Modi, the seventh, because Lagna is the second pada of Swati. Fourth pada of Ashwini. First pada will end at 3 degree 20 minutes. Second pada will end at 6 degree 40 minutes. Third pada will end at 10 degrees. And the fourth pada will end at 13:20, right? So 11:36, it will be the fourth pada of Ashwini in the seventh house. And what is the fourth pada? That is moksha. Freedom. So in the seventh house matter, in marriage, what he did, he left his wife, right? Freedom. In the horoscope of Mr. Adolf Hitler, Shan is in Ashwini third pada, Kama. He was desirous of acquiring power. Third pada, na? Kama. Desire. Kama is a desire. So Sun in third pada, desirous of acquiring power. And Mercury is in the first pada, Dharma. So as I told you, Adolf Hitler was good in oratory, right? Was he an orator? No. Giving good speeches, delivering good speeches was his duty. Because he wanted to take people's support to do what he wanted to do. Do you get the difference? Do you get the difference between these three? The pada, first pada, second pada, third pada, fourth pada will make the difference, will make a very high difference. And that high difference should be kept in mind always. Fine? No problem? The nakshatra course, you have to make very extensive notes. Now, the special part. Stories. Okay. So in some course you can learn one story, two story, three story. I have taken all the stories from Vedas and Upanishads, right? All the stories. Not one, not two. For Ashwini Nakshatra, I have some 34 stories. Okay. So 1-2 story, no, 34 stories I have. And I'm not going to tell you the 34 stories. It will be a highly long class then, right? 34 stories will take me some 3-4 hours to tell you. So the crux of the story, right? The crux of the story. Let me go. First of all, okay, so I have notes. So first of all, the name Ashwini is... The name Ashwini, what does Ashwini mean? Ashwini means a Ashwa means a horse. And Ashwini means someone who is like a horse, right? But see, horse is a what? What you say? Like, let me tell you one particular thing. My name is Shubham, okay? Who is Shubham? I am Shubham, okay? But what does Shubham mean? Getting my point, meaning is something different. I am Shubham, okay. But what does Shubham mean? What does the word Shubham mean? That is a different thing, right? Shubham means someone who is auspicious, someone who is benevolent. That is Shubham. And that is not me. Okay. So Ashwini, Ashwa. Ashwa means something which is vyapak, something who is all pervasive, something which is present everywhere. Getting my point? Ashwini means something which is everywhere. It is made up of two words, Ashwa, Imi. That is something which is all pervasive. Getting my point? Something which is all pervasive. It have a tendency of being present everywhere. Ashwini deals with the basic qualities that are present everywhere. Ashwini indicates very base instincts. Getting my point? Whenever there is something happening in Ashwini, you don't think that it is very complex. It is very basic. What do I want to say by this? Like try to understand my point. If you want to see what type of addiction is caused by Ashwini, if you want to see what type of addiction is caused by Ashwini, it will not give you a very high level addiction such as drugs, etc. It will show you very basic addiction. Very basic addiction such as alcohol, etc. Right? Alcohol is present in the Shastras also. The Asuras used to drink alcohol, right? So the signification is very basic. Okay. Ashwini indicates something very basic, all pervasive. Ashwini generally deals with the basic elements, the basic building blocks of anything. Go to my point. The basic building blocks of anything. Shloka. because it is from a Veda. It is from Taittiriya Samhita. Yat samastam bhuvanam ashnute ekrasena vyapnoti anya jyotisha vapnoti. That's the shloka from where this thing comes. So then, so like the crux of another story is story number two. Okay. There are waters, and in the middle of that water, there is an element. Who is that element? Why I tell you that Ashwini is related to Rama? Why I tell you that Ashwini is related to Rama? Because the definition of Ashwini, ek rasyena vyapnoti anyah jyotisha vapnoti, says that there are waters everywhere, and in the middle of water there is something which covers the complete sky. As I told you, Ashwini means covering. Something which covers the whole sky. That is Vishnu. Vishnu is inside water. And from the navel of Vishnu, a lotus will spring up. And on that lotus, there will be Brahma who will create the world, right? That's why Ashwini is the first nakshatra now. Getting my word? That's why Ashwini is the first nakshatra. So Ashwini is also teja, brilliance. Ashwini also means brilliance. He have the brilliance to rise from the depth of water to the highest of sky. That is what Ashwini is. From the depth of the water to the highest of the sky. That is Ashwini. So Ashwini indicates brilliance. Ashwini indicates something which is brilliant, finer qualities. As I just told you, any planet in Ashwini, there will be finer qualities of the planet. Getting my point? Finer qualities of the planet in Ashwini will be there. That's why Venus in Ashwini is very good for Raja Yoga. Because the finer qualities of Venus have came up. Understood my point? Any planet in Ashwini, the finer qualities of that planet will be there. Understood? For an example, see, this is the horoscope of Rabindranath Tagore. Okay. How to use it? How to use the particular knowledge? This is the horoscope of Rabindranath Tagore. And he is considered a very fine poet, right? Gitanjali, a very fine poet. If you go, and the poet is all about his way to look at the world, his way to perceive the world. The second house is having Mercury writing in Ashwini. Third pada kama. Is he known for spiritual poems? Kama. He's known for poems depicting beauty. Kama. Getting my point? Finer tendencies of it. Fine writer. Very fine writer. His writings are considered classic. He is not any XYZ writer on Amazon. Nowadays, anyone can write a book and publish a PDF. Publish a book, right? Anyone can do. But he is not that. He is Rabindranath Tagore. Immortal classic, right? Ashwini indicates, as I told you, in the starting, Ashwini indicates things for which you will be known even after death. And right now, this is Mercury. Okay, you know what? You have to understand one more thing. You have to understand one more thing. Nakshatras also get afflicted. Okay? If there is a malefic in a nakshatra, it will get afflicted. Getting my point? If there are malefics in a nakshatra, it will get afflicted as well. Malefics in a house, the house is afflicted. Malefics in a nakshatra, nakshatra is afflicted. So Adolf Hitler is having son, malefic in Ashwini nakshatra. So Ashwini nakshatra got afflicted and his name is not taken in a very good sense. His name is taken in a negative sense. But for Rabindranath Tagore, there is only Mercury in Ashwini. And Mercury, when alone, is a benefic planet. So it gives the finer qualities. It gives the finer qualities of Ashwini Nakshatra. Got it? That was the story number two. So you know story number three. There are two horses in Ashwini. One of them rules over the water. And another rules over the fire. So the Ashwini is an amalgamation of different qualities. Ashwini is an amalgamation of different qualities. Generally, the main motive of Ashwini is not known. It is an amalgamation of multiple things. It will include, it indicates two different tendencies in the same person. Okay? It indicates two different tendencies in the same person. For an example, let's go to the chart of Adolf Hitler. According to him, he was doing good to the Jews. But the world will look at him as a villain. Right? He was doing good to Jews, according to him, but the world looks at him as a villain. Two different tendencies. Other charts I will not make a comment about. And let's come to the horoscope of Mr. Gandhi, Mahatma Gandhi. So the ascendant is 8 degree Libra. So the 7th house have to be 8 degree Aries. And 8 degree Aries will be the third pada of. It will be the third pada of Ashwini. Third pada of Ashwini in the 7th house, Mr. Mahatma Gandhi is coming together of two different tendencies. He had 4 children and he was doing experiments with truth while remaining a brahmachari. Ashwini indicates this great transformation, two different tendencies. It can indicate a person who is highly talkative, but will think before speaking. These two tendencies doesn't match. Generally, people who speak a lot tell a lot of lies and they don't think before speaking. But that's not the case with Ashwini, with second lord in Ashwini, with Mercury in Ashwini, no. The person will speak a lot, but at the same point of time will think before speaking. Right? Coming together of two different tendencies. Venus in Ashwini, the person may look like a sexual pervert, but he is not actually. Venus in Ashwini, the person is generally misunderstood. He looks like that he can be a pervert, he's a pervert type of person, which he actually is not. Getting my point? It is coming together of two different tendencies. A car which looks like a racing car runs like a bullock cart. Is what Ashwini is. Going further, story number four. Story number four had a shloka, Ashwanto Punnigradao Rajano. Ashwini Nakshatra. The two Ashwinis in the Ashwini Nakshatra, the two Ashwini brothers, they are the brothers, right? Ashwini Nakshatra, they are the brothers. I'm not telling you the basics of Ashwini Nakshatra. How does Ashwini look like, etc.? What is the image or symbology of Ashwini? There are other astrologers who teach you basics, right? I don't. So Ashwini is generally one body in two faces. So they are two brothers. Ashwini Kumara are the two brothers who are in the same body, joined together. And they both, so sometimes they are taken as two brothers in the same body. So one body with two horse faces. And sometimes they are taken as two different people, two different kings standing together. So symbology is used sparsely. Generally in the text which relates to Karmakand, it is the one body with two horse faces. Generally Upanishad and the Vedas have it as two kings. And both of these kings are Punyavan Raja. Both of these kings are highly blessed. Punyavan is someone who have done good deeds in the previous life. And because of that good deeds, he will enjoy in this particular life. So when you have a planet in Ashwini, you are going to get blessed in the signification of that planet. Because you have done good karma related to that planet in the previous house, right? Ashwini relates doing good karma. Got my point? That is what Ashwini is, good karma. Be very sure, make it very sure that you don't do bad karma related to the signification of the planet who is in Ashwini. Because if you do bad karma, it will be highly detrimental for you. Okay? It will be highly detrimental for you. There will be great suffering. Even one mistake related to the planet in Ashwini Nakshatra will be very troublesome. Understood? In some classics, the sky and the earth is shown as a couple, and that is depicted as the Ashwini Kumaras. What does this mean? That Ashwini Kumaras indicate, the Ashwini Nakshatra indicate a whole lot of fluctuation. What does it indicate? A whole lot of fluctuation. Ashwini Nakshatra indicate great fluctuation. Getting my point? Fluctuation, sometimes the result can be very good. Sometimes the result can be terribly bad. Okay? It can give you very good finances. If you do good karma, it will give you very good finances. If you do bad karma, it will give you very bad finances. Ashwini Nakshatra is full of ups and downs. Stability is not there in Ashwini Nakshatra. There are two horses, right? And horses are made to run, right? So these two Ashwini Kumaras run, they are also very much related to speed. And because being related to speed, there is no stability. Venus in Ashwini Nakshatra, sometime very good marital life, you will think that she is my only soulmate. And sometime it will be a very bad relationship and you will think, why I am stuck in this relationship. Getting my point? Venus in Ashwini, sometime a playboy, sometime extremely single. It indicates great fluctuation, great ups and downs. Next story. I will forget the number counting, so I will be telling you next story. You keep on writing how many stories I have covered, right? Of course, I cannot cover everything that I have written in my notebook. Still. And you know what? Ashwini Nakshatra also makes an astrologer. Many people having a prominent Ashwini Nakshatra are into astrology. Because in some other stories, one Ashwini brother is told as night and another Ashwini brother is told as day. So Ashwini Nakshatra from this story indicate two things. First of all, a strong connection to astrology. Ashwini is very strongly connected to astrology. And second, Ashwini have no fixed working time. Do you get my point? It have no fixed working time. Okay. If the 10th Lord is in Ashwini, or if someone is born in Ashwini, moon is Ashwini, ascendant in Ashwini, etc., then there is no fixed time of working. The person is generally very haphazard in his work timing. No schedule, no timetable. Also indicated by Ashwini. Sometimes Ashwini is also taken as sun and moon as a couple. Sometimes Ashwini is also taken as sun and moon as a couple. Acha, okay. Let me tell you something. If you go by the story of how Ashwini Kumaras are born. So son copulated with his wife and then Ashwini Kumaras were born, right? That is the story. If you go by that story will tell you there is a lot of love, etc. But in reality, Ashwini is very bad for marriage. That is the difference. Getting the point. So which story to rely upon? Because there are multiple stories, and when you just know one story, that can be problematic. Getting my point? When you only know one story, that can be problematic. You should know multiple stories. The Ashwini Kumar that is born from the copulation of son and his wife, Sangya, are different. And these Ashwini Kumaras are different. These Ashwini Kumaras are the kings and the healers. Ashwini also indicates a lot of medical support or a lot of medical uses. Ashwini generally indicates someone who is into self-medication, researching medicines themselves. There are two nakshatras which are very much connected to self-medication. Ashwini and Sadamisha. Right? Nakshatra of doctors. Ashwini and Sadamisha. So the next historian takes them. Historians generally take Ashwini Kumaras as kings. I have already covered that. Ashwini Kumaras are always understood as a couple. Ashwini Kumaras are always understood in duality. Ashwini Kumaras, Ashwini Nakshatra generally, always indicate the two sides of the story. One very good and one very bad. Okay. Whenever there is a play of Ashwini, be very careful that it indicates multiple parts of it. Getting my point or not? It indicates multiple parts of it. Got my point? Suppose someone is having Ashwini in their 10th house. Okay. The person will cheat his own guru and will tell his students not to cheat their guru because that comes with bad karma. Two different side of stories. Whenever there is Ashwini playing, whenever there is the role of Ashwini, you understand that there is a side of story that is hidden from everyone's eyes. Understood? Whenever there is Ashwini, you understand that there is a side of story that is hidden from everyone's eye. Got my point? That's why I always say Ashwin is related to blackmailing. Because the other side of the story is there, always, always. The other side of the story is always there, right? You know, like recently the Zomato case. Other side of the story. Okay. Generally, in multiple places, it is told that Ashwini Kumara, that one of them is moon and one of them is sun. That is one story from Brahman. One of them is night and one of them is day. That is one story from Upanishad. And these stories are from different places. Okay. But these stories are told very repeatedly, very often. So what's the way out? If one of them is night and one of them is day, if one of them is moon and one of them is sun, then how they are a couple? How they are a couple? So Upanishad answers this. Upanishad answers this. So there is a particular Upanishad which talks of sun. Okay. And that Upanishad tells us that Ashwini Kumaras are a couple because they indicate the evening time. Specifically the morning, evening. The time between the time before sunrise, Brahma Muhurt, is indicated by Ashwini. That is the reason Ashwini is considered. Ashwini is the first nakshatra. That is the particular reason. Getting my point? Got it? Let me write it in note. Ashwini nakshatras are related to Brahma Muhurta. I will come to this part later on. So there are a few praises for Ashwini. The next story. Vastisma charta asito petva viv kadedam ashwina yuvam abhi devam agachteya. O Ashwini twins, you walk in night. So Ashwini nakshatra indicates someone who works overnight. Right? I told it before. Ashwini doesn't follow a timetable. They have a very haphazard sense of time. They generally work overnight. There is something. There is a saying in Hindi. That is din dugni raat chauguni tarakki. That means two times success in day and four times success in night. That literally means that. So generally, there is a case where someone was not successful some months ago, overnight success. You know this concept, right? Overnight success. That overnight success is indicated by Ashwini. Overnight success, phenomenal success, setting up new records is indicated by Ashwini. Like Rabindranath Tagore, Mercury in Ashwini, he set up new records in writing. Adolf Hitler, Sun in Ashwini, he set up new records in Tanashahi. Tanashahi kalis me karte monarchy. He set up new records in monarchy or whatever it is called. Right? And it is told that both the Ashwini Kumaras are dark like clouds. And for this particular reason, Ashwini Kumaras rise in the sky in Brahma Muhurta, and because they are black, they are not seen. The workings of the Ashwini is generally underground. The workings of the Ashwini is generally hidden. The workings of Ashwini is generally out of the sight. Getting my point? This is how the Ashwinis work. Their workings, etc., will not be known. So Ashwini, as I told you, blackmailing. So Ashwini is also very much related to voyeur, blackmailing, doing things, being hidden, doing things in a way in which you are not known. Right? That is what Ashwini does. It indicates that thief tendency of, you know, like working very silently. You know, there's a quote like work silently and let your Ferrari make a noise. That quote is very much relevant to Ashwini. Okay. And generally, Ashwini is not very easily pleased. In the same shloka, it is told that, O Ashwini Kumaras, you people walk in night, you people are black like clouds, and for this particular reason, I was not able to see you in the Brahma Muhurta early in the morning. Now I am doing a yajna, and tell me when you will come to the gods who are participating in the yajna to take the offerings of my yajna and make it successful. That does mean that Ashwini is very difficult to please. Whichever planet is in Ashwini, there are very high standards of that planet in your life. Any planet in Ashwini, there are very high standards of that planet in your life, and that standards are very difficult to match. That those standards are very difficult to meet, match, whatever you say. Right? Criteria. The criteria that Ashwini sets is high. Ajo Havit Ashwina Vartikavam. You both are called by Usha. Usha is the sun rays as a goddess. So you both are called by Usha. O kings, O the Ashwini kings, you save other kings from dying. Other kings are swollen by sun, and Ashwini Kumaras save them from dying. So Ashwini is very much related to saving. You know what? Ashwini is also very much related to reading, learning. Right. They are very much related to saving. Saving an ancient knowledge, saving a particular branch of thinking, that is indicated by Ashwini. Something which is perishing, something which is going to disappear, saving that particular thing also comes from Ashwini. So there are both the traits, right? There is a blackmailing trait of the night. There is a saving trait of Ashwini Kumaras as kings. If the Ashwini Nakshatra is having a malefic planet, Sun, Rahu, Ketu, Mars, Saturn, then the negative implications will come. If the Ashwini Nakshatra is having good planets, Mercury, Venus, Jupiter, Moon, then the positive aspects of the Ashwini will come. Getting my point? Generally, moon is not taken a benefit while analyzing the nakshatra, because moon and nakshatra is given an altogether different level of importance. Right? Generally, it is a mixture of both things. So Ashwini Kumara is, Ashwini person is saving something from dying, saving something from perishing, saving something from getting extinct. But his way of saving is not very good. His way of saving is not very appreciable. Getting my point? His way of saving is not appreciable. That's not very good. And they are, you know, how do you come? that Ashwini Kumara's Ashwini Nakshatra is bad for marriage because they are known as Nasatya. And Nasatya means the one who is kept separated. Nasatya means something which is kept separated. So that sense of separation, that separation comes from Nasatya. Okay, so, you know, there are many more stories and I will just tell you that story quickly. So Ashwini Kumaras are the two kings who are worshipped for the welfare of people, or two kings who work for the prosperity of his people, prosperity, protection, etc. So as I told you before, Ashwini Nakshatra is very prosperous. Ashwini Nakshatra is very good for professional success and financial success. I told you this in the starting. Right? For an example, there is a shloka. Ribhishe Atrim Ashwini Vanitam Unnyatu Sarvaganam Swastihi. Sun and earth together took fire from blow of earth with help of rain, which gave the birth to seeds and became benefited. There is one more point. Ashwini Nakshatra is very good for childbirth. Ashwini Nakshatra is very good for procreation. Ashwini Nakshatra is very good for production. So generally people having a prominent Ashwini Nakshatra, generally people having prominent planets in Ashwini Nakshatra, having the fifth lord, Venus or the Jupiter in Ashwini Nakshatra gives very good progeny, give quick progeny, give progeny without any difficulty. And so quick progeny or happiness from children is also indicated by Ashwini Nakshatra. That is also something that needs to be taken into consideration. One more particular thing. There is a disease named as leprosy. Leprosy is also indicated by Ashwini Nakshatra. Suffering from hereditary disease, suffering from disease which have no cure, such as leprosy, cancer, diabetes, etc., is also indicated by Ashwini Nakshatra, specifically leprosy. Suffering from leprosy, suffering from hereditary disease, and suffering from diseases which have no cure is indicated by Ashwini Nakshatra. For an example, Hitler have one testicle only. So incurable, cannot be done anything. Okay. Ashwini Nakshatra. You know, there was a Kanva Rishi, there was a sage by the name of Kanva, and he was blind. And Ashwini Kumaras gave them the sight, gave them the light to see. So Ashwini Kumara is also, Ashwini Nakshatra is also related to enlightenment. So all these negative tendencies of Ashwini we have learned, but over the time, as Ashwini will progress, as the Ashwini person will progress, as the signification of the planets in Ashwini mature, there is enlightenment, there is transformation, there is rise of spirituality in the end of Ashwini also. Got my point? Ashwini is also transformation. Okay. And Ashwini Nakshatra is also very much related to speaking, oratory, and musical instruments. Okay. Ashwini Nakshatra have a strong voice, melodious voice, and also is interested in playing music, etc. So Ashwini Nakshatra is also strongly related to music and voice. Right. Just a second. Right, Ashwini Nakshatras, actually Ashwini is a grantor of wishes, actually, technically. So to the son of a sage, there was a sage named Nrishadputra. There was a son named Narsh, who was the there was a sage named Nash, who was the son of another sage named Nishad, and Ashwini Kumaras gave them the power to listen. So once again, related to music, as I told you, playing musical instrument and listening. So Ashwini Nakshatras are strongly related to music as well. You know what, Ashwini, Jupiter and Venus. So do you know, we know that the planets set in the sky. Right, ast ho jata hai na, right? Planet get helical setting, planet set in the sky. So when the planet sets in the sky, when a planet is combust, he is invisible. Okay, when a planet is combust, he is invisible. And generally the time when the planet comes out of combustion is considered very important. The time when the planet comes out of combustion is very important. And that time decides the result of the planet for the next time until and unless it becomes combust again. Okay? Do you understand my point? And this is one of the very important things that I think no one is going to teach you. That is a very important part. You know, for many people, exalted sun is good. For many people, debilitated sun is even better. A living sun aside, sun is not into this combination. Suppose for someone, exalted Jupiter is very bad. For someone, debilitated Jupiter is also very good. What is the difference? The difference depends on the sign when the sun came, when the Jupiter came out of combustion. When planet goes into combustion, he is into a recharge mode. And when he comes out of this recharge, when he is born again, it is told that when a planet is combust, he will go behind sun. It is like the planet died. And when the combustion will end, when the planet will come out of the sun, it is a new birth for the planet. And when Jupiter and Venus come out of combustion, when Jupiter and Venus come out of combustion after midnight and before sunrise, Jupiter and Venus are called Ashwini. Then in that scenario, when Jupiter and Venus comes out of combustion after midnight and before sunrise, Jupiter and Venus are called Ashwini. Yes. So the results of Jupiter are very fast paced. Ashwini Nakshatra is to be worshipped after midnight and before sunrise, one thing. Right. Ashwini is for female. Like we have talked for male up to this extent. A specific result for female. Generally, Ashwini Nakshatra for a female indicates good control over senses. So for male, it is almost characterless. For male, Ashwini is characterless. If it is 10,000 characterless in the profession, etc. For female, it have a very good control over senses. Ashwini. Ashwini also indicates those people who don't postpone something to future. Ashwini Nakshatra indicates someone who will do something then and there, he will not postpone the result to the future. Okay. Ashwini is also related to patriarchy. As I told you, the sense of belonging from a clan. Ashwini also very strongly indicates the love and devotion to one's own country. Rashtradrama. The love and devotion to one's own country, giving life for one's own country, the dedication to one's own country and land is also indicated by Ashwini. Other than this, Ashwini also indicates someone who walks very fast. Ashwini indicates a woman who is recently married. Ashwini also indicates a very fast chariot and the god of death. Okay. So So these are about Ashwini. Now coming to the important part, the padas of Ashwini. So my class is interesting, boring, then interesting. Okay. To understand it, the first Ashwini Nakshatra, first pada, great power, very energetic, very powerful. But there are problems related to anger. Ashwini Nakshatra, first pada, okay? There is high level of anger. Person wants to do everything very quickly. There is a strong sense of that I want to gain power and recognition. The person is highly libidinous. The part is highly libidinous. There are generally problems related to fever, boils. It indicates a whole lot of accidents. Along with this, the person will be in the habit of Ashwini Nakshatra, like, you know, Ashwini Nakshatra first pada. The person will be in the habit of having hair on this particular chin area of the face. He will not have hair on the complete beard, but he will specifically have hair on the chin area of the face, specifically big ears in the, like, you know, this chin area of the face, right? Along with this, his nose will be very small. Shoulders will be very small. He will have a very strong voice. He will not like when someone disrespects them. Not very good to look at. He also have eyes which are, you know, like very close to each other. Right? He will be a thin person. And karma. Interesting topic. Ashwini Nakshatra first pada indicates that the person used to insult his servants in the previous life, or in, like, you know, there have been multiple lives before. However, the problem is related to insulting the servants. Problem is related to insulting the people working under you, or not giving them the appropriate level of respect that they deserve to people working under you. Ashwini Nakshatra first pada also indicates, as I told you, a strong hereditary disease. Okay, problems related to bones. And Ashwini Nakshatra first pada, at least one big shock in professional life. And, you know, like Ashwini Nakshatra first pada, person have planned something. The stage is completely ready and you are just about to get the thing. But at the last moment, at the last point of time, the reward will be cancelled. The reward will be delayed. Ashwini Nakshatra first pada, there will be at least one chance in life where you have to give up something that you have earned after much hard work. Ashwini Nakshatra first pada indicates someone who has been awarded with Bharat Ratna, and because of some reasons he have to give that Bharat Ratna back. So just you will be given some award and you will be enjoying that, yes, I got the award, and someone will announce from this stage, sorry, we have taken a wrong name, you are not the winner, someone else is the winner, please return the trophy. Okay. Ashwini Nakshatra first pada, return the trophy. I think that needs to be done there. Okay. Ashwini Nakshatra second pada. So the second pada is very much more focused on creation, creativity, reproduction, and sexuality. High level of sexuality, high level of libido is indicated. Other than this, the person is very good in mathematics, the person is very good in calculations. Ashwini Nakshatra second pada, sure shot astrologer. not if not astrologer, then at least whatever the person says, whatever he will say, that will come true for sure. His predictions will come true for sure, guaranteed. Marital life is generally a disaster, but the person is very handsome, beautiful, and good looking. And very handsome, beautiful, and good looking. The person is very good in either very sweet tongued, or you know, someone who is very much into eating fat, or someone who makes very good food. The person is generally blessed from the mother's side, but the defect is that his father, even though he have a father, his father will be nearly absent. Despite having a father, he will have to take his responsibilities himself. The father will be of no use. And other than this, maximum time the person will be indulged with useless extra responsibilities. He will have to take the responsibilities of his siblings, mother, etc. also. The second pada of Ashwini. Okay. Along with this, if the person goes to the second pada of Ashwini, if the person goes to the foreign land, there is a very huge transformation in fortune. Either the person becomes very fortunate after going to the foreign land, or very unfortunate after going to the foreign land, whatever be the case. Right? Along with this, a person born in Ashwini Nakshatra, second pada, is generally blessed by happiness and mental peace. But if their mental peace is disturbed for any particular reason, if the mental peace is disturbed for any particular reason, in that scenario, they will become addicted to something. Specifically, alcohol addiction is very strongly indicated in Ashwini Nakshatra, second pada. Generally, a cool and calm demeanor. These people are generally flirt. Generally, they will be flirt, and for marriage, it is bad. I told you before, right? They will be very handsome, but not very fair in complexion. Handsome, but not fair in complexion. Right? They will have, their arms will be extremely long. Shoulders will be broad. Their forehead will be, very small. The forehead will be very small, or the hairs will be covering the maximum portion of the forehead. Right? Their collarbones will be very prominent. Their eyesight will be very good. They will have a very very broad face and a very big nose. He will be a very good speaker, but his legs will be problematic. He will have problems related to the leg. His leg will be weak. The second pada of Ashwini, right? Ashwini Nakshatra, third pada. Third pada, Ashwini Nakshatra, problem related to speech, problem related to communication, problem related to mismanagement. Ashwini Nakshatra, third pada, you want to say something, people understand something else, and there is generally a misunderstanding. Not with one person or two person, there is a misunderstanding with everyone. Problematic. It is generally problematic. And Ashwini Nakshatra, third pada, generally gives you diseases related to skins, diseases related to chest, diseases related to veins. Problem in blood flow, problem in circulation is there. Blood flow and blood circulation is there. The person should not be in business. Ashwini Nakshatra, third pada, the person should not be in business. If he is in business, there will be many difficulties and many challenges. Rather than business, he should look at for self-employment. The life of the person, Ashwini Nakshatra, third pada, the life is very unstable, haphazard, and full of chaos. There will be no stability in life. And person, specifically, Ashwini Nakshatra, third pada, person will take some very immature decisions in the starting of his life, and that immature decisions will haunt him for a lifetime. Right? Generally, he will be bald or nearly bald, or there will be great loss of hair. He will be like fair in complexion, but his arms will be defective. Generally, he may have one or both broken arms. Right, and his eyes and nose will be very good and attractive, well built. He will be like very well learned, scholarly, interested in fine arts, writing, speaking, drama, music, dancing, etc. And he will have problems related to legs and problems related to leg. And one more peculiar trait I will say, at least once in life, okay, he will advise someone to run away from home or will be a big catalyst in someone running away from their home. This third Pada of Ashwini, at least once though. This not have to be there. Okay. Ashwini Nakshatra fourth Pada. Like the most unfortunate part is Ashwini Nakshatra fourth Pada. Health, great health problems. Strong alcohol addiction. If not supported, then it can be converted to, you know, like multiple different type of addictions and different type of defects. Along with this, not very good relationship with parents. The person is mentally and emotionally very harassed and tormented. The person generally visits prostitutes. Or if not, then he will have multiple relationships. Marital life will be bad. His father generally, the result may not be applicable 100% because the whole horoscope needs to be considered, right? So take it with a caution, right? His father will not complete his duties to a great extent, right? You know, so his mother have to take a very strong part in their life, very strong. Their mother have to run the home very strongly. Generally indicates a mother who is a homemaker as well as into earning. Right. The authority of these people, these people are the Ashwini fourth Pada. They are always challenged. There is one or the other enemy 24/7. They should never take a loan. If they take a loan, the loan will be a problem for a lifetime. There are many enemies, and specifically Ashwini Nakshatra fourth Pada people should never ever, never in their life do anything without protection. Want to drive a bike, wear a helmet. Want to drive a car, wear a seatbelt. Accident anytime. And generally there are very strong indication of loss of something. Loss of body part, loss of limbs is generally indicated, or even theft. Theft of things are very strongly indicated for Ashwini Nakshatra, fourth Pada. The person's eyesight is also very weak. The person is easily frustrated and short-tempered. His nose is not very prominent and his nose will look very, like very bad to look at. Okay. He will love to, you know, like walk from one place to another. He will be a traveler, will not like to sit on a particular place. Or rather, in other words, say, you know, there will be no stability in his life. Even after purchasing a property, he will not be able to live in that property. He will have to live on a rented property. Even if he gets to live by some way or the other, in that scenario, his life will be filled up of troubles. You know, there will be one problem or the other problem in the home almost every day. Right. Along with this, his hair will not be good. He will have a very thick hair. Generally, if males, they will also have hairs on the chest, which is an indicative of poverty. Right. And generally, they will have no siblings. Even if they have siblings in that scenario, the relationship with their siblings will not be good. Right. And generally, these people are in the habit of not taking food at proper times. Their eating habit, their eating schedule will be very much disturbed. Right. So these are the results for people born in the different Padas of Ashwini. As promised, story in the end. Sorry, remedy in the end, right? So before we go to the remedy, just a small thing. So what we are doing, we are covering the mantra of the nakshatra that gives you a whole lot of clue about the nakshatra. Then we are covering all the stories about the nakshatra. Then a specific result, karma, you can say, or result. I tell it as result. You may refer it as karma, pending karma, whatever you want to do. Right. So the mantra of the nakshatra and understanding it. Mantra of the nakshatra is not easy to get. Even if you get it, the meaning of that nakshatra is very rare to get. Even if you get the meaning of the nakshatra, to interpret it according to the experience. The first part. The second part is the stories of the nakshatra from different sources, multiple stories of the nakshatra, and understanding how they can be used in the prediction. The third part is the specific result of, the different padas of the nakshatras. And in the last, the remedy is what we are going to cover. Started with Ashwini, and hopefully we are going to cover all the 27 nakshatras. Right? Because it is a part of the course, nakshatra course. It is a part of the nakshatra course, which is divided into four parts. So first part we have done, this is the second part, and the third part, right? So the course is divided into four parts. The first part we have covered, and the first part covered the classification of nakshatras, Urdhumukha, Adhumukha, etc. Second part is this that you are now listening to or watching. The third part and the fourth part is remaining, and all the four parts are into the same course, right? So the four parts are not the different courses, right? It is not four different courses. The four parts are in the same course, right? Coming to the Ashwini remedy, generally, let me tell you something. Generally, nakshatra have a mantra. Mm-hmm. And chanting that nakshatra mantra is the remedy. But that is not a very strong remedy, is what I will say. Because the nakshatra mantras are in the Brahmanas and Upanishads. Getting my point? And Brahmanas and Upanishads were written at a time when the worship of gods like Ashwini, Yama was prevalent. Nowadays, do you have a home? Do you have an image of Ashwini Devata at your home? Do you have an image of Ashwini Devata at home? You don't have. We don't have. Now we don't worship Ashwini, right? So remedy number one is the Ashwini mantra that you can do. And doing the Ashwini mantra will relieve you from miseries related to Ashwini nakshatra. That the nakshatra mantra sometime else, some other time. Right now, for now, there are a few remedies that I will like to mention about Ashwini nakshatra. There is, a god. There is a god named Hayagriva. And Hayagriva is worshipped in South India, specifically Andhra region. Worshipping Hayagriva, that is an avatar of Vishnu. That is an incarnation of Vishnu. Worshipping Hayagriva, there are stotras for Hayagriva also. And mind it, stotra is 100 times more powerful than a normal puja. Mantra is 100 times more powerful than stotra. Meditation is 100 times more powerful than mantra. And samadhi is 100 times more powerful than meditation. Samadhi, everyone doesn't get it. Meditation, if you think that sitting in the posture and having your hands like this, you do meditation, then you are a bigger fool. You are a big fool, right? Mantra, if you think that you can, have any mantra from internet or any book and can start chanting, that no, then no one can help you. The only safe side is stotra. Because the mantra needs initiation. Meditation needs a proper guru to teach you. And samadhi is far beyond any reach. Okay. So, Hayagriva is a deity worshipped specifically in the Andhra region. And there are many stotras of Hayagriva that you can refer to. Remedy one. Remedy two. As we have already discussed that, Ashwini nakshatra indicates Brahma Muhurta. So waking up at Brahma Muhurta, taking a bath in Brahma Muhurta, or waking up at Brahma Muhurta and doing Gayatri Mantra in Brahma Muhurta is one of very efficient remedies for Ashwini nakshatra. And third, as I told you, Vishnu or Sri Rama. Rama because he did Ashwamedh Yajna, and Vishnu because he is in the center of the ocean, are also related to Ashwini nakshatra. So for Vishnu Sastranam, or for Rama, Ram Raksha Stotram. Doing these two things, Vishnu Sahasranam for Vishnu and Ram Raksha Stotram for Rama, are highly effective remedies for Ashwini Nakshatra. Right? So thank you for watching the class. Let's meet in the next class.